Today I want to take a look at how swap can be used in Proxmox, how different configurations may affect performance, and perhaps what might be a better setting for your different configuration. Proxmox gives you a little setting for setting up swap on some different disk types, and if you use EFS, doesn't let you use any swap in the installer at all. So I want to see how it's used, different configurations, how it affects it, and also pull from my experience of using many different Proxmox systems over the years to see kind of what might be a better swap configuration for your system. A couple quick notes before I dive into the technical details is that swap is typically only going to be used on systems that have relatively high amounts of memory utilization, so if you're barely using your RAM, this probably won't apply to you almost at all. And also, this is based off my testing on my system and the workloads I've seen. Your workload might be different and these rules might not apply here, so run some tests before following these ideas. But let's get into a quick disclaimer of kind of what swap is in Linux and what it does. Swap, or sometimes called page file on other OSs, is effectively extra memory that is stored on disk instead of in system memory. And the advantages of using swap is it allows you to have more memory available to processes so it doesn't just kill it when you use up all the physical memory on the system. The disadvantage is these drives are going to be significantly slower than your internal memory in the system, significantly harming performance if you have to use swap versus using additional system memory. So let's take a look at what those performance impacts are in my first experiment. So the first thing I did was just ran a standard FFmpeg encoding process. And then what I did is I closed down the amount of memory the host had access to. You can adjust the kernel parameter here to limit the amount of RAM a system has access to and run testing like this for yourself. I also added this Optane 905P drive as my swap drive as kind of a best case scenario when it comes to a swap drive. And when doing that, as expected, I see significantly longer time required to complete the task. So swap is going to make your system slower. Another thing I found very useful when working on systems with swap is using dstat and its little paging parameter. I found monitoring dstat's paging IO a much better indicator than the amount of swap being used if swap is going to affect performance on your system. If your system is actively going to swap, that's likely going to hurt performance. But a lot of the times the system moves unneeded pages into swap and that won't affect performance in itself. But Linux allows for more than just devices like SSDs to be used as swap drives. It also allows for memory to be compressed and then stored again as swap. This is very similar to memory compression on Windows 10 and 11 and also in macOS. And in order to set this up in Linux, look at zram guides. Effectively, you're creating a RAM disk that compresses the RAM again and stores it on memory. And when using my little zram configuration, I was able to use 4 gigs of RAM to run an Proxmox host and my VM and just compress those about 2.5 to 3 gigabytes of memory into about 600 megabytes, getting about a 4-to-1 compression ratio. The problem is it takes CPU cycles to do this. And in my case, it was slower to use zram and recompress it on the RAM than it was to just swap out to a drive. But this Optane drive is a best case scenario when it comes to swap. So I tried using a slower SSD, like an 850 Evo here. And the 850 Evo was slower than the Optane drive, but it was also still significantly faster than using zram. In my test, I was doing video encoding that was using a lot of the available CPU resources. And that likely made zram look worse here. So in your workload, zram might do better, but it didn't look that great to me and probably isn't going to be a great configuration for many here. The other thing that might be interesting to look at was zswap. And zswap compresses files before storing it on swap, as well as having a little bit of a cache of what data is stored on swap to hopefully speed up swap. But in my case, it just slowed things down as well. It was likely designed for using mechanical hard drives for swap, whereas the IO is going to be the slowest by far, and adding a little bit of CPU overhead doesn't matter, but with SSDs these days, IO is less of a bottleneck and saving CPU cycles speeds things up. So while Linux has these available technologies, at least in my experience using Proxmox with this test VM, it didn't seem to be that helpful. So I'd probably stick to just using an SSD on its own if you want to use a device as a swap device. Hard drives are going to be way too slow to use as swap devices in most cases. And if you plan to have much swap IO at all, I'd make sure your device has relatively high write speeds and endurance. So look for kind of these higher end data center drives and not cheaper drives, which often slow down significantly with a few more writes. The other test I ran with this limited RAM situation was to see if it's better off putting a swap device on the host and having it swap out, or putting the swap device in the guest and let the guest swap out. The one big difference is if you put it on the host, all the VMs are going to be affected by this slower memory. But if you put it on the host runs just fine as it isn't doing any swapping. But I did see significantly better performance when I had it on the host. And that's likely because many parts of the Proxmox system itself could be swapped out, giving me more available memory for the guest. So if you are having to swap, it's likely going to give you better performance to do it on the host, but it does have the downside of it will affect all of your VMs, versus if you have the guest swapping out and give it less memory, it'll only affect that VM. Also, a lot of systems don't want to swap out their programs, so having the host swap out can kind of be a way of cheating and giving VMs access to more memory than they really have access to work with. Not typically recommended, but could be useful in some testing to see what a VM does if you give it way more memory than you'd normally have access. The next set of testing I went into looks at swappiness and how Proxmox handles that. Swappiness is what Linux calls its tunable parameter to offload parts of unused processes to disk or swap, so that way you can use that memory to store disk cache. Linux, like almost every OS, uses available memory to store a disk cache to hopefully speed up disk I/O, and oftentimes it thinks it would be a better idea to swap or remove items from memory that aren't being used so it can have a bigger disk cache and speed up disk I/O parameters. In Linux, you can edit this using swappiness, and it can go from 0, which means it should only have to swap out when it actually needs to prevent an out-of-memory error, to 200, where it will very aggressively swap out memory to swap. This gets quite a bit more complicated with ZFS and its arc. ZFS is often used in Proxmox systems, and the way it uses its arc or its read cache is different than Linux's main file cache, and sometimes reported as incorrectly. You can configure the arc size when installing in the Proxmox's installer page here, or you can change this parameter here to change the amount of memory or bytes that are used as arc as maximum. But it will try to use less if processes need more. The other thing is arc is often not reported very well and is reported as used memory by a process instead of cached memory, which is why in Proxmox you often see quite a bit of memory used on a system with no VMs running, because that's ZFS's cache and probably being reported incorrectly. So as a quick little test, I fired up a few VMs on a system without any swap, and as you can see, as I fire up more VMs, that means that the ZFS arc size will go down as needed to save space for those VMs in memory. The bug or issue that I noticed in this testing is that Proxmox will kill VMs if swappiness is set to 0. In modern kernels, 0 should mean that it swaps out only if needed to prevent an out-of-memory error, but in this case it would kill multiple VMs even if I had plenty of swap available. So that doesn't seem right. When switching swappiness to 1, that fixed the issue and the VMs would get swapped out to disk instead and they'd stay running. The other issue I had was when Proxmox would kill a VM using the out-of-memory killer, it didn't say anything in the web interface or errors. I'd love to see a little error that says, hey, I killed the VM because it's out of memory, you should add memory to the system, or just monitor this better. This is not how it should be going. It just kills the VM and shows it as not running anymore with no messages in the bottom messages panel. I think that's suboptimal and I'd love to see them include better monitoring in that case. And also, you should probably always set swappiness to 1 or more if you're going to use it, because it had issues with it not really working as expected of swappiness set to 0. But as expected, compared to the default setting of 60, the system would be much more likely to gobble up ZFS's arc or other page cache on Linux instead of going out to swap with a lower swappiness value. Now, let's take a look at how this kind of looks in the real world. So I've worked with many different Proxmox systems with many different amounts of memory, but oftentimes these systems are almost overspec'd with maybe a half a terabyte of RAM and only 100 some gigs of RAM actively being used. ZFS might gobble up another 100 gigs in this case, and we're at 200 out of 500. And even with the default swappiness value in Proxmox of 60, it's not going to be swapping out with that much memory in the system. But when we do clamp down on memory, it does start to swap out. And I think what a better parameter for a lot of people is, instead of having swappiness set to 60, set it to maybe 1. And then you swap as kind of an indication that your memory's low. If you're starting to swap out, you should probably add more memory or reduce the workload on the host. I did try running a workload on my system where I'd use a lot of swap intentionally to see how the VMs would perform. So I set up my personal home server with roughly 3 Windows VMs and 4 lightweight Debian Linux VMs running on 8 gigabytes of RAM with one of these Optane 905 drives used as swap. And I had 8 gigs of RAM basically always being used, as well as like 28 or 30 gigabytes of swap, with almost constant data going in and out of swap. And you'd notice some stutters, but it worked surprisingly well a lot of the time. I can't recommend a setup like that, but if you're in a system where you have a system with maybe soldered RAM or something you can't upgrade any more of, and you're running multiple VMs where they're idle a lot of the time, and you're not super critical of a workload, swap could be a way to get a little bit more out of an existing system and might be worth taking a look at. And putting together the data I got from my testing, as well as the real-world examples that I used, I think some of my general ideas for running swap on Proxmox are this. First of all, if you're going to use swap, you want to use it on an SSD, don't use it on a hard drive, and zram and zswap didn't seem to make sense in my testing. Next thing, if you aren't using swap at all, make sure to keep an eye on memory and keep it relatively low. If it's getting much over 70-80%, especially if you're running large VMs that could likely utilize the rest of the memory, you'll probably want to either lower the amount of VMs or add more memory, because Proxmox's out-of-memory killer just kind of kills a VM without telling you which VM or that it was an out-of-memory killer. The next thing I'd likely want to configure swap as is swappiness as relatively low, and have moderate amount, maybe just a handful of gigs depending on how much system memory you have, and use it as an indicator. If swap is starting to be used with a low swappiness value, that means you're running up pretty much against the limit of swap in of RAM in your system, and you're nearly maxing it out, and use that as an indicator to add more RAM or lower the amount of RAM the VMs are using in the system. You can force high amounts of swap to be used in a system as kind of a crutch for not having enough memory, but it's not recommended. You get odd slowdowns at times, and I'd only do it if you have to. If you have soldered RAM in a system that you can't upgrade, or you have to run the bigger VMs with no other option, I'd almost always try to keep swap off and running on these systems. Hopefully this was an interesting video that looked into swap that really isn't talked about or documented that well in Proxmox, and gave you some ideas for things to look at or configure on your Proxmox system. Let me know if you've had experiences setting up or using Proxmox swap in Proxmox before, and how that's gone for you. And thanks for watching.